Hello everyone and welcome to my channel, On the Hook Crochet, where we talk about wearable crochet style. The whole video is going to be about wearable crochet style. Today, let's find out what's on the hook. So I invite you to grab your favorite crochet project and crochet while I'm talking to you. Don't waste any time just watching me, but you can listen to me and kind of glance up every now and then and work on your favorite crochet project. I know you have one. I know everybody out there has a crochet project. It's a whip and it's waiting for you to pick it up. And while I'm chit-chatting, you can work on your crochet project. First of all, I want to talk about a special project that I have in the works with Creative Grandma, Glenda at Creative Grandma. She has asked me to ask my viewers and subscribers to take a survey sponsored by Premier Yarns. And this survey is to let Premier Yarns know and to let big box stores know, like Walmart, Target, Hobby Lobby, Michaels, Joann's. Apparently this survey will be sent to them and to let them know that the yarny community like ours, the crocheters and the knitters, would like to see more yarn in the retail space, and not to close up the yarn sections of the big box stores. I know that my Walmart has pared down its yarn selection so much that it's about half of one side of one aisle. And when you're talking about yarn, it takes up room, and I understand that. And they do store a lot of things on the very top shelf that you can sometimes reach, sometimes you can't. But the basic piece of the yarn space is gone. I mean, it used to be prolific. And there may be other Walmarts in other areas that have larger yarn selections, but mine does not. And I also traveled to a very large Walmart, one of the largest I've ever seen. And the yarn department was just as small. It was about half an aisle, and it was disheveled. There was no good yarn in there. I mean, there was a little bit of yarn in there, but there wasn't enough for a sweater quantity, for example, of some of the yarns I was looking at. They just don't have the selection that they used to have. And there are a lot of people who are interested in crocheting and in knitting as well, and would buy from Walmart and from other big box stores if there was a better selection. So this survey is to let them know that we want to have more yarn in our big box stores so that we can go and touch it, pick it up, feel it, and we don't have to order everything online. Or we don't want to go to the big box store and see one skein of yarn and then go order it online. That's not helping the store at all. So the survey link is down in the description box, and I would really appreciate it if you take a couple of minutes, that's all it takes, to answer the questions on the survey, submit it, and this would help us quite a bit in the yarn community to let our wishes be known to some of the big stores that could carry more yarn, but they choose not to, and they may not even know we exist out here. So if you would take the survey, I'd appreciate it. I told Glenda I would send my viewers and subscribers there, and this will help her reach her goal of 1 million surveys. I think we can do it. If we have enough support from the yarn community, we can get 1 million surveys sent in, and that would speak to some of the buyers of those stores. Sometimes they just don't know. So we're sending the survey in for that reason. So if you would, go down to the link and take the survey right after we finish this video. Please do that. All the people who buy yarn will be grateful. And maybe the big box stores need some input from us because they don't know that there are so many of us out there that order online from companies they don't even know, like Ice Yarns. And if you would take the survey, I'd appreciate it, and I will let Glenda know by sending her a link to this video that I have announced it and that I approve. I think it's a wonderful thing to do, send a survey and let these companies know that we're out here and we are ready and willing and able to buy the yarn from their stores. So if you would take that survey, I'd really appreciate it. Second of all, thank you I got a couple of Christmas cards in my post office box. I appreciate it. One from Barb in Orlando and one from Ileana from Miami. And Ileana actually has a YouTube site, but she didn't send me the link and I couldn't find it quickly on YouTube. So Ileana, if you want to send me that link, I will put that in the description box of a future video and y'all can go check her out. It's brand new, so that's probably why I couldn't find it right off the bat. Now, to talk about ice yarns, last week I told you about a sweater that I was making, and it's black and white mohair, and this is what it looks like. I showed you this, and I had determined that I was going to run out of yarn, and I certainly will, but I ordered some from Ice, and they actually had the exact yarn, so I'm in good shape there. I'm excited. I'm going to finish my sweater, and I've already worked on it, and I have this much done. I've got the back finished, so it turned out to be 21 inches, and I'll show you how long it is on me. It's right about, you know, at the top of the leg, right here, and it looked like it was going to be long enough because I'm making it very boxy. So since I'm making it boxy, I didn't want to make it long and boxy, but just boxy. So I've already started the front and I've gotten this far on the front. I was excited I had my yarn, and so now I'm proceeding with that sweater, and that'll be the next one, hopefully, that I can finish up. Tomorrow, I have a pattern release for my cobblestone sweater, and later today, I'm sending an email out to my community, which will have a nice discount on there that you can use on any pattern in my Etsy shop. So if you haven't already joined the community, go down in the description box and click the link, join the community, and you'll get an email this afternoon with a good size discount for all the patterns in my Etsy shop and for the cobblestone sweater. In particular, I want y'all to take a look at it. The video comes out tomorrow morning at 8, and I'll be on there showing the sweater. I'll model it for you, and we'll talk about the design elements and what I made it from, and that way you can decide if you want to purchase the pattern or not. It's a video that explains the sweater and how it's made, and maybe you can get some ideas from that. I don't know. But you can make it from any yarn you want. You can make it from any hook size you want. That's how I design my patterns, and somebody asked me if I would talk about that, and I'm going to right now. My patterns are designed so that you can use any yarn you want, any size hook you want. What I do is I guide you through the process by taking your own measurements, you chain up what it needs to be to make the back of the sweater or whichever side of the sweater we're working on first, and then you also decide how long the sleeves are going to be, how long the sweater will be, or the top will be from the neck to the waist and to the bottom of the top itself. So all those measurements are yours. I don't size my patterns. They don't come in a size extra small, small medium, 3X, 6X. They don't come in those sizes. What you do is take your measurement, fill it into the pattern, and then proceed with the directions that I give you in there on how to make the sweater itself. So it's designed for people who can follow directions and who have a tape measure. That's basically what they're designed for. A crocheter that's a beginner can make most of my patterns, and I dare to say all of my patterns. So there you go. That's how I design the patterns. They are not sized. You can't say, will this fit a 3X? Well, if you take your measurement and make the sweater the way I ask you to, then more than likely it's going to look good on you, it's going to fit you, and it's going to fit the way you want it to. It's not going to be sized to a certain number of chains, a certain number of stitches, and you have to meet a certain gauge to make the sweater. Now, that's not to say I won't ever use a gauge, because eventually maybe I'll make a sweater that you do actually need a gauge, but my focus is really to make sweater patterns and top patterns that will fit you with your own measurements. So that's how it works. Now, yesterday I received an order from Ice, and like I said, I received my mohair and a wool yarn, which I'm really excited about. So glad I got that. I was worried that they might run out, so I'm glad I did get that. And the order was here in 2 days, which is totally amazing to me, because it actually does come from Turkey. The return address is Turkey, not somewhere in the United States. So I don't know how they do it, but it's amazing. So what I do when I go out on ice yarns, and say I needed one package of this yarn, and when I click on one package, the shipping costs more than the yarn did. All right, so then what I do is I shop around a little bit and see if there's something else that I'd like to buy so that I'm not spending more on shipping than actually on the yarn. So what I did was I found a couple of types of yarn that I wanted to try, and I ordered those, and I ordered a sweater quantity in both because I didn't want to run out of yarn. And these were on the sale rack. If I'm not mistaken, this Rosito was actually on the sale rack. This is 60% wool, 40% nylon, and it's absolutely gorgeous. Look at the colors in there. I'm going to leave this up for 1 second. This green is more of an olive green. That's more my color. See, when I work with the light, it makes it look a little different. And then, of course, there's gold, and there's a little bit of pink and gray in here. It's really a potpourri of colors. But I ordered a sweater quantity, which is about 1,500 yards. This is a size 3 weight yarn, so it's going to take me a little while to make. But since it's wool, I'm going to have to get busy on it pretty quickly. And it's a self-striping. It appears to be a self-striping yarn. So I need to make something kind of plain out of this. So I'll probably just pick one of my patterns and make a sweater from those. It wouldn't be a cobblestone. It would probably be a cozy posy or something like that is made plain, you know, across the body of the sweater. There's not a lot of interest there. So the interest can be in the velvet yarn that I made it from, or this type of yarn that stripes across there. So that's how I'll decide what kind of sweater to make from this. I know that somewhere I made a list of what I was going to make from this, and it's disappeared. It'll probably appear on my desk again today somewhere, but right now I don't remember exactly what I was going to do with this, but that's more than likely what I'll be doing with it. It's just making a simple sweater from it because it is a self-striping yarn. I'm having a little trouble with my light. I apologize for that. I also ordered a sweater quantity of this, which is a boucle yarn. I don't know if you can see that. Yeah, a boucle yarn. And what a boucle yarn is, it's a yarn that is knobby, as I would call it, knobby. And this is a size 3. So what I'm going to do, no, it's a size 2, excuse me, a size 2. And what I'm going to do with this is hold 2 strands together and make a boucle top or short sleeve shirt, maybe something like that with it. But I'll be holding 2 of these together. And I wanted to make a top out of this cream color. This is beautiful. And I bought 2 packages of 8 balls, so I have plenty of yarn to hold it together. I think it's 1,250 yards held together, so I've got 2,500 yards or something like that of this tiny yarn. It is pretty tiny, though. It is a number 2, and on each ball is 160 meters, so it's got quite a few yards on it. I didn't do the calculation, but it's close. So I have those 2 yarns that I have that are new that I'm going to do something with probably around Christmas or right after Christmas because they're wool, and I will definitely want to make those up before the weather turns warm. Now, it's going to be a while. It's just now. It's not even winter time yet, but it will be a while before I get to that. I also wanted to make a little sweater jacket for my grandson, and I know y'all, a lot of you make baby stuff. You make amigurumi, which I don't make. You make socks, which I haven't made. And I find it necessary to make a baby sweater because I have one grandson that I have not made anything for. Now, he's wearing some of the sweaters that I made for his older brothers, and it's really cute and all to see him in his Christmas sweater. But I feel like I need to make him something that's his own. So I found this. This is obviously done in pink, and I'll be doing it in blue. But this is from Yarnspirations, and it's called the Baby Bear Crochet Hoodie. And I wanted to make him a sweater with a hoodie on it so cute with the little ears. And I'll be making this in a blue stripe. And I'm going to make it right by the pattern and with the same yarn that it calls for. And it's called Red Heart Bunches of Hugs Prints. And I bought one ball because that's all it takes. It's got a huge number of yards on the ball. I think it's 678 yards on the ball. So I bought one ball and I ordered it. I found the exact color that I wanted and it's in blue. And I will show you the progress on that. I have to get going on this because I really wanted it to be a Christmas present for him. And if it's not too difficult, I'll probably be able to finish it pretty quickly. It's not too many instructions. It's only one page. And some of that is for sewing it together, which I know how to do already. And it has a hood on it, which is what I was interested in. So what I'm going to do is because he's between a 12 and an 18 month size, I'm going to up the size of the hook and make the smaller size. I'm going to make a 12 month sweater and I'm going to use a size I instead of an H. And of course I don't have an H hook because I lost my H hook. As soon as I get my order from Amazon, I ordered one on Amazon the other day. It should, really should be here today. I ordered an H hook and as soon as that appears on my porch, I will find that H hook. That's usually the way it works. But then I'll have two. And that's really good because an H hook is a great hook to use. And H, I, and J are three of my favorites. And I use those for, I think those are my go-to hooks. Mostly the J hook, as you know. All right, so let's get down to business. I know y'all are waiting to find out who will be the gift recipients this week. Before I do that, so I wanted to say what I was wearing today, and a lot of y'all have made this. A lot of patterns have zoomed out of my Etsy shop for the curly cowl pattern. This is a beautiful, beautiful cowl. I made this from two strands of mohair, pastel mohair from Ice, and I'll put the link down in the description box if you're interested in buying that. They are now wrapped on cakes. They are not sold in skeins anymore, but it's a beautiful, beautiful yarn. I really like it. And made in my curly cowl. The first one I made was a latte cake by Karen, a Karen latte cake. And it didn't even use the whole cake. It's pretty easy to make. And it goes fast. And like I said, I know people that have made several of these for Christmas. And they make a statement. They're large and they're easy to wear. And if you make it out of something fairly neutral, then the person you give it to can wear it quite often. And it is warm. I made it out of wool, so it's warm around my neck, and I really like it. I really like this pink one. And I'll probably wear this to church on Sunday because this is the third week in Lent, and according to the liturgical calendar, the third week in Lent, and that is the Sunday when it's just kind of a break between the first half of Advent and the second half of Advent. So the color, the liturgical color is rose, and this is perfect for that. So I'll be wearing this on Sunday. Now, to get down to business for giving away the gifts this week, I'm excited to give these away. These are nice gifts. And so I really got excited when I thought, I'm just going to give that away. This is the Vitalana ambient worsted, which is 100% Peruvian Highland wool in the colorway whiskey. Beautiful, beautiful shades. Somebody corrected me. That was right. I said hues. But these are actually lots of shades of kind of a light brown color. Very pretty, kind of almost copper. Really pretty. And there are 201 yards on the ball. And this is a size 4-way, of course. It's worsted. So it will make, you know, a hat and or a pair of gloves or a cowl. You can make a cowl out of this. And next week, I'm going to show you a cowl that I made from the other hank of this that I received. And we'll look at that next week. But right now, I'm just going to give this away because I won't be using it this winter. I also am giving away the Dawn Blush in the same wool. Peruvian Highland wool, it's the same yardage, 201 yards, everything's the same, just the color is called Dawn Blush, very beautiful, and I'm going to let you put it in a cake. So So I just go out as a hank, and you can just roll it by hand, or you can put it on your Swift. You can get that done. The third gift is the Karen Simply Soft Party Yarn, and I really had more positive comments about this than these expensive knit crate yarns. Honestly, everybody wanted these party yarns. So there'll be two balls, two skeins of this going out to gift recipient number three. So let's turn the camera to the computer and see who the gift recipients are.
Okay, so here we are with our camera pointed toward the computer. And we will get the comments. There was no keyword this week, so everybody who put a comment down is in the running. Looks like 536 people participating. Thank you so much for that. And let's go over here and find out who the gift recipient is for the whiskey colored Vita Lana knit crate worsted yarn. And the winner is Winona Hutchins. Winona, you are the gift recipient for the Vita Lana yarn in whiskey. Let's pick another winner. Okay, here we go to start. And this gift recipient will receive the Dawn Blush Vita Lana. Her name is Natalie Hook. Natalie, you will be receiving the Dawn Blush beautiful worsted yarn. I really like it. All right, and now let's find out who wins the Karen Simply Soft Party Yarn in Spring Green. And there are two skeins of that, and that will go to Rhonda Moomaw. Rhonda Moomaw, you have been chosen as the gift recipient for the third
gift. So congratulations to all three gift recipients. If you would, please email me your mailing address, and I will get those out to you first thing next week. Thank you all for watching. I appreciate you doing the survey. Don't forget to go down into the description box, click that survey, go out there and participate so that we can all get together and maybe make a change in how things are done in the yarn departments of some of the stores out there that we would like to shop at. Some of them that aren't big enough. They just don't have enough yarn. So I hope you have a wonderful weekend. Don't forget to check your inbox for my email that'll come out this afternoon. And there's actually a link to the Etsy site there and to the new pattern. It will already be out on Etsy, and you can use your discount there if you want to buy the pattern, or if you want to wait till the video comes out in the morning at 8 a.m. That goes to all of my subscribers on YouTube. And so if you get the email today and you're a member of the community, you'll have a first look, a preview of the pattern that's coming out. So join me tomorrow for the release of the cobblestone sweater, and again on Monday when we'll find out what's on the hook.